So what an exciting final to get us off the mark on finals day here in Singapore. Next up is women's doubles, and it's a match where history and record books will be rewritten, whichever pair wins. Because if Matsutomo and Takahashi were to win, they'll be the third different Japanese pair to win in three consecutive Super Series titles. If Yule and Pedersen win, they'll be the first European pair for 25 years to win the title here in Singapore. Then history made in the men's singles with the two players from India. That's the first time it's happened at a Super Series event. It happened at Grand Prix Gold twice, but never at Super Series level. Then women's singles, and the top two players in the world, Tai Su Ying, in her third final here, up against the world and Olympic champion Carolina Marin. Then we finish with men's doubles, Bowen Mogensen against Li Junhui and Liu Yuchen. Well, as far as the Super Series standings are concerned for the women's doubles, we've actually got three pairs equal at number 10. But when you look at the top of that list, the winners from last week in Malaysia, well, Fukushima and Hirota went up from number 5 to number 1. And in fact, the top three on that list are the three pairs who have won the first three Super Series tournaments of the year. In fact, six of the top seven pairs on that list have been in a Super Series tournament final this year. So women's doubles, very strong indeed. And that strength in women's doubles is exemplified by the draw from quarterfinal stage. Five different nations, seven seeds. When we got down to semi-finals, the top four seeds, all three Olympic medalists, and the top four ranked pairs in the world of badminton in those semi-finals. And it's fitting that it is the world number ones, Matsutomo and Takahashi, against the world number twos, Yule and Pedersen, who will contest today's final.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please welcome our finalists for the women's doubles final. The number one seeds from Japan, Misaki Matsutomo and Ayaka Takahashi. The world number one beat will please contest the final again.
The Olympic champions,
last year due to injury,
Misaki Matsutomo and Ayaka Takahashi, the world number ones.
In the semi-finals last night. Please give it up for the Olympic champions.
Today,
Matsutomo
contesting a 20th Super Series tournament final, a fourth here in Singapore. Three times they've reached the final previously, and they've never won the title here in Singapore. The Danes, Christina Pedersen and Camilla Rutajul, finalists here 3 years ago, making their first appearance, in fact, here since losing that final 3 years ago. Trying to become only the second women's doubles pair from Europe to ever win the title here. It's been 25 years since the only European pair to win this title, the one back in 1992. A certain Jill Clark and Gillian Gowers won the title that year, having won it 2 years previously. What happened to that Jill Clark? Is it really that long ago? My goodness me, time flies. The only final today featuring the number one and two seeds. Misaki Matsutomo, 25 years of age, born in Tokushima on Shikoku Island in southern Japan. Not the tallest of athletes, as you can see, but the world number ones enjoying their third spell as world number ones. Ayaka Takahashi will turn 27 in 2 days' time, 3 days' time, from Nara Prefecture. Kashihara City is the city in which she was born. And as far as the Japanese pair are concerned, well, it was only in the second round against Ashwini Ponapa and Siki Reddy where they went the full distance since then. It's been two straight games, including the semi-final in a repeat of the Olympic semi-final. They beat the Olympic bronze medalists, Jung Kyung Ung and Shin Sung Chan. The Danes, the left-hander, is 33-year-old Camilla Rutejul, born in Skagen, right in the north of North Jutland. And she really is tall, isn't she? She's about 6 foot. And she won the mixed doubles title here back in 2010 with Thomas Laybourne. So this her third final at the Singapore Open, her second in the women's doubles. Her partner, 30-year-old Christina Pedersen, who will turn 31 next month. And they're enjoying their 72nd week as world number twos. Their matches so far, all of them in two straight games, and it's been a tough draw. Two very good Chinese pairs in the first two rounds, including Bao Yixin, who is a two-time former champion here with her new partner, Yu Xiao Han. Quarter-final against the World Championship bronze medalists, Fukuman and Yonao, and semi-final against Chang Ye Na and Li So He, who, of course, beat them in the All England final. So there you can see, this is the 15th meeting between the two pairs. Last meeting was in the semi-final of the Super Series of finals as we look at our court officials. This is actually the third meeting between the two pairs since the Olympic final. Met in the final of the Japan Super Series event and then that semi-final, the Super Series finals. On my right.
And on my left, Ayaka Takahashi and Misaki Matsutomo, Japan. Christina Pedersen to serve to Ayaka Takahashi. Level play.
So the number two seeds, Yul and Pedersen from Denmark, hoping to become the first European pair to win this title for 25 years. So this is the 15th meeting between the two pairs. Love. It's only, surprisingly, the third meeting in a tournament final, the Olympic final, the Japan final, and now here in Singapore. It's also the first time since the Denmark women's doubles final that we've had a women's doubles final at Super Series level that's featured the number one and two seeds. So first final since last October. Oh dear.
Serves over.
This error there from Matsutomo.
1-2.
Just long.
2-2. Serves over.
Well, I mentioned the fact that if Matsutomo and Takahashi, as we look at Kim Nielsen, the Danish coach, if the Japanese pair were to win, it would rewrite the history books because apart from Chinese players winning three consecutive tournaments or more with different players or different pairs, it is only the men's doubles discipline where we've had three different pairs from the same nation win three consecutive tournaments. That was in 2012 when three Korean pairs won in Japan, Denmark and France. And of course, with a Japanese pair, Tanaka and Yonemoto, winning in India, and last week, Fukushima and Hirota winning in Malaysia. It would be extraordinary if Matsutomo and Takahashi could become the third different Japanese pair in three consecutive Super Series tournaments to win the women's doubles title.
Serves over. Four all.
Five, four. Nice good placement of the smash from Matsutomo.
Five, all.
Defense, my goodness. Good rally. Oh, my goodness. Well, what happened with that last one? No, strings didn't go. Just missed time shot.
6-5.
Finals that this Japanese pair have contested previously was 2013 and 2015. Last year they reached the final but had to give a walkover to Maswari and Polly.
6-6-0.
And if I remember correctly, it was Matsutomo who had an injured ankle a year ago. Hence they gave a walkover in the final. So it's actually only the third final they've contested, and so they've reached the final now for a fourth time.
7-6.
It's gone long. Again, good placement on the smash from Matsutomo. It's amazing with these two pairs, number one and two in the world, but neither pair has a particularly good record in Super Series finals. Matsutomo and Takahashi, 19 previous finals, only winning seven of them. Pedersen and Yule, 13 previous finals, only winning four of them. Possibly got the hardest smash in the women's game. Camilla Yule. Oh, brilliant. Well worked by the Olympic gold medalists. Well-constructed rally. Park Jubon, head coach in Japan. Well, I think we'll be pretty happy with the start at the moment. Yeah, look at the way they rotational play. One's committed one side to the other, moves round to cover any possible reply. Jima, another coach.
20 seconds.
Let's go wide. Yeah, call from Camilla Yule, because her partner was going to hit that. That's a clear demonstration of just how severe the sideways drift is. She was doing a lot of that earlier in the tournament. Straight smash and expecting the straight reply.
11,
almost like
12.
A sides attack position. Normally you think of an attack position with one at the front of the court and one at the back. She was looking to move forward after the straight smash. Two flick serves in a row. Good work from Misaki Matsutomo. Oh, took the half chance. A safe shot would have just been a block, but she went for the kill. And she made it count. Service error 14, apiece, I believe. 12. Oh, good return. Makes amends after the service error with an excellent 13, return of serve. 14. And it just rolled the racket head at the last moment, looking as if she was going to play it down the backhand side, but keeping it straight at the body. Did she change her mind? Certainly seemed to snatch at it in total mistime of the shot. Brilliant. That's a fabulous smash. One straight down the middle of the court, then one angle on the forehand side of Matsutomo.
15.
Deep into that forehand corner. Very, very clever placement. He's wondering as well. They've both missed time shots. Nothing wrong with the timing on that one. And good placement of the smash too.
15-17.
Long. 17-17. Terrific.
I checked my feet. 18-16.
Yep.
Serve's over. 17-18.
Ooh, challenge, yes. That looked awfully close to me. Yes, it got the line. What a great challenge. And that makes it 18 all. Quite content just to give the shuttle a little more height on the defensive play. Early stages of that rally. And look at the reaction. Into the lead at this crucial stage, and now on a run of four straight points. It's two game point opportunities for Yule and Pedersen. There's the height on the lift again, on the defence. It's gone long. Opening game on five straight points for the number two seeds, Camilla Ruud de Jong and Christina Pedersen. From 16-18 down, what a comeback by the Danes. ...19 minutes for that thrilling opening game. Sets of coaches still giving advice to the players.
Second game. Level. Play.
Well, since the Olympic final, those two pairs met.
One,
the two
love
matches since. The scoreline's one all in head-to-head since then. Desperately short lift from Yule. Good judgment. Slightly to go wide. The body. Smash direction and smash placement, so important in women's doubles, probably more important as the Japanese pair get the lucky net, but probably more important in women's doubles than any other discipline, because if these top female players can defend men's smashes in mixed doubles, then this can certainly defend smashes from women, and obviously women's smashes aren't quite as hard as men's smashes, so you've got to rely more on placement to force a weak reply or hit a winner. Perfect serve.
5-3.
Yeah, it was clearly in. Just bounced a little off the top of the tape. Normally that slows the shuttle down.
Serve over. 4-5.
Well missed. I don't think she meant to miss it. No fresh air shots. And the shovel landed out. They're keeping up the pressure. They're taking all the half chances at the front of the court. And that is what an awful lot of doubles is about. Singles, you can't afford to take a risk and get off balance. Doubles with a partner there, you can afford to go for it, even if you are going to be left out of position. Well, that's one net court apiece, isn't it? Immediately points to the sideline, says to her partner, was that going wide? I'm sure it was. This one. Yes, indeed it was. Hannah Grain a questioning look towards the line.
Seven.
Oh, that was going out. But so was that. Brilliant. Well played from Matsutomo. Even though she took two shots that I'm convinced were going wide of that left sideline as we look down. Looking at that from the other end of the court. See anything that's played down that left-hand side is tending to drift wide. Longest rally of this second game, I suspect. Following a very similar pattern to the opening game. A three-point advantage at the mid-game interval in both games for the Olympic champions, Matsutomo and Takahashi.
Twenty seconds. Camila, get ready.
Umpire David Schwerin from Austria calls the players back to court.
Play.
Well, I think the big difference over the last 18 months, maybe 2 years with this Japanese pair, has been Matsutomo's capabilities and improvement at the front of the court. Serve. Time and time again she does that. The good serve anticipates the third shot and plays a winner from it. Wonderful smash. separating the shuttle in between the two Danes.
13-10.
Yeah, there wasn't much of a gap either, but they both left it for the other. That really is perfect placement. Oh, yeah. Beginning to really make their attacking play count, the Japanese 15, Olympic champions.
12-15.
Japanese coaches 16, in deep discussion. 12. Yeah, pleased with that. Big nod of approval from Kai Nakajima. Looks very 17, much as if we will 12. Be treated to a third and deciding game. Oh, what a rally. It's going wide. Yeah, very, very good rally. The attacking play switching from one pair to the other. Well, that's the longest of the match so far, I think. Oh, that's going well wide. Yeah, not taking into account the drift. And Matsutomo and Takahashi, 2 points away from taking this second game and forcing a decider. Yeah, loose serve. Not what it deserved.
13-19.
Japanese players just asking the umpire if she moved before the serve was struck. I think it was just a loose serve.
Game point 14.
Six game point opportunities. Game all 21-14. 40 minutes into the final. And it's one game apiece.
Twenty seconds. Final game. Level.
So third and deciding game.
One love. Thank you. Serves over. One all.
Attacking play seems to be more effective from this near side of the court. What? That would all make sense with the drift. Double the net. Brilliant placement on the attack. Serve is over. 5-2. Yeah, exactly the same again. See, the Japanese pair are so intent on trying to push the shuttle down Yule's backhand side, but Pedersen, after serving, is intercepting it. A handsome lead at the moment, 5-point advantage. It was ambitious.
Seven.
But perhaps the only option. Be careful on those. You've got to give the shuttle enough height. Or maybe even block it. Oh.
9-4.
Unbelievable. Terrific. Brilliant. Oh! Well, the dive initially from Christina Pedersen. How on earth did they keep in the rally for so long? Look at that. And it was a spectacular dive in an attempt from the left-handed Yule, this final one. Look at that. Talk about effort. Brilliant. Took the half chance. Obviously, Kim Nielsen has been talking about play at the front of the court, his gestures there. Now that's a fantastic play from Camilla Yule. And the Danes change ends in this deciding game with a 6-point advantage.
Camilla, Christina, get ready. Time is up. 11-5.
So have the Danes got enough of a lead?
Play.
Well, they're the end where they struggled in the second game. That's a wonderful smash, it really is. Takahashi getting 12, caught five. Between should I defend backhand or should I defend forehand? I'm getting in a big muddle in the end. Ayaka Takahashi.
Over. 13-6.
You'd think the Japanese would start trying to vary the return of serve, because once again, from her left-hand court, Christina Pedersen intercepting the third shot with the attempted push down her partner's backhand side. I've noticed that the Danes have asked to change the shuttle and the Japanese haven't wanted to, but they have been allowed to change it. Good return.
Service over. 14-8.
It's a little bit loose, and it's pounced upon, as it, indeed it should be. Missed it. It's gone wide. Oh, I wonder if that could be a costly miss. The 6-point deficit has been halved to 3 points. And that missed smash from Camilla Yule, I said at the time I thought it might be costly. Matsutomo not thinking about the drift.
Oh.
Bosch, who was back well to that flick serve. What a terrific smash as well. Good placement, good power. Well, I remember in the Olympic final, the Danes were up in the deciding game. 19-16 up. They couldn't close it out. We're not at that stage yet. She's been taking those half chances up to now. She's been making them count. But perhaps a little bit of fatigue, perhaps a little bit of nerves. Who knows? And now just 2 points the deficit. Oh, that's wild. My goodness gracious. Clock ticks over the hour mark. Whilst the Danes have a 3-point advantage, this is far from over yet. Brilliant rally. Speed of movement, speed of shot, speed of reaction. This is incredible. And the Danes now just 3 points away from becoming the first European pair for 25 years. Win the women's doubles title here in Singapore. Almost got in each other's way. Brilliant. Good interception from Matsutomo. What a rally again. Yeah. And the hard physical work pays off for the Danes. Two tantalizing points from the title. Rally of the match. Good serve. Watches it. Oh, it's landed in. Was that hope rather than belief?
15-19.
Yeah, just inside the back line. Opportunities for Pedersen and Yule. Good serve. That's gone wide. Rackets go in the air. And the Danish combination of Christina Pedersen and Camilla Yule become the first European winners of the Singapore Super Series, the Singapore Open, for 25 years. They reverse the result of the Olympic final. And they come through three hard games. Oh, for goodness sake. Getting a yellow card. What on earth was that for? Oh, that's just ridiculous. Oh, that's just put a damper on what should have been a very, very happy moment for the Danish pair. Well, a lucky fan is going to get the winning racket. Another one, the winning shuttle. And a wristlet as well. Well, what a tremendous women's doubles final. 21-15 in the deciding game, in a match lasting an hour and 5 minutes. Well, the delight quite obvious. Their first Super Series title of the year. It's their fifth Super Series title in total. This the winning moment, the return going out. And let's see what the yellow card was for. I don't understand it. Because having won the match, they went and shook hands. But they will be absolutely delighted with that win.
And let's have a chat with our women's doubles champions. We've got here with us Camilla Ritter-Yule and Christina Pedersen. How are you guys feeling?
I'm feeling okay. No, of course, so happy. Amazing match. Actually, I can't believe we are the champions.
Well, I heard that you guys actually had plans to go to the beach today because you didn't think that you would get it this far. Tell us a little bit more about that journey.
When we saw the draw, we could see that we told to each other that we had to play almost five finals to reach the final, because it was so strong opponent there. So for this tournament, we've been really, really good, taking one match at the time, and I think that's the reason why we stand here today.
Well, that's absolutely wonderful. Of course, you guys can go to the beach tomorrow. But going into your performance, you said you took them one match at a time. What do you think really helped push yourselves to this point now?
Actually, I think the tournament last week gave us a kick in the ass. We have to believe in ourselves. Even though we are getting older, we are still very strong. And that's what we proved today. We just love to be here in Singapore. The arena is amazing. There's a lot of drift. The crowd is amazing. Thank you.
That's absolutely wonderful. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, your women's doubles champions.
I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I believe every lie that I ever told. Paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold. Somewhere I heard that life is a test. I've been through the worst, but I still get my best. God made my mold different from the rest. Then he broke that.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony of the OUE Singapore Open 2017 Women's Doubles. We would now like to invite Mr. Luke Lim, Deputy President, Singapore Badminton Association, to present the plaques. Let's hear it for our runners-up in the women's doubles from Japan, Misaki Matsutomo and Ayaka Takahashi.
For the Olympic champions, Matsutomo and Takahashi.
Ladies and gentlemen, your champions of the Singapore Open 2017 women's doubles from Denmark, Camilla Ruta-Yule and Christina Pedersen.
The champions, after a 25-year wait for European players to win the women's doubles title here, Christina Pedersen and Camilla Yule deliver in fine style.
Mr. Nigel Pang, Honorary Treasurer from the Singapore Badminton Association, to present
Super
the
Series
and
title in total. Last year was the best year. They had two titles last year in Japan and Hong Kong. Spare a thought for Misaki Matsutomo and Ayaka Takahashi. Four finals here now in Singapore and yet to win the title. We'll take nothing away from the Danes. Today they played an ideal tactical
once again, ladies
game.
And gentlemen, please give it up for your champions.
And they leave Singapore as champions.
say today. We've got 65 countries already.
Well, two excellent finals here so far on finals day at the Singapore Super Series event. Next up is men's singles. And for a first time ever, two players from India contest a Super Series men's singles final. After the men's singles is women's singles, and the top two ranked players in world badminton at the moment. Tai Su Ying in a third final here, hoping it'll be third time lucky against the world and Olympic champion Carolina Marin. And then we finish with men's doubles. Boa Mogensen against Li Junhui and Yu Chen. Well, of course, it means we cannot have all five titles going to five different nations. But as far as the men's singles Super Series standings are concerned, the top four have all been in finals this year. Last week, of course, Lin Dan won and he shot up 10 places to number four. And Li Chongwei, having played two Super Series tournaments of the three and two finals, went up to number one. But the two players that we're about to watch are not on that Super Series standings at the moment. Six different nations involved from quarterfinal stage, only two seeds. And then in semi-final stage, for only the fourth time in Super Series history, all four men's singles semi-finalists unseeded. Second time it's happened here at the Singapore Open. So it means we have an all unseeded men's singles final. And for the first time ever, it features two players from India.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's welcome our finalists for the men's singles finals. Please welcome from India, B. Sai Praneeth. Now this is his
what
first World Super Series
for
final,
Sai
and he'll be hoping
Praneeth.
To make it to the top of the
party.
Sai raced past Korea's Lee Dong-kyun, 21-6, 21-8.
Prior to this week,
one-sided
it never